In this season, everybody around the world has been affected. At A21, absolutely. You know, we've got 19 offices in 16 countries. So every week during this whole pandemic season, we've been meeting like everyone else. I call it in the upper Zoom room. And so we all have been in the upper room for over a year and a half. And I said to them right from the beginning, you know, none of us have chosen this to a degree. No. We're all in varying degrees of lockdown. And, you know, some countries, Australia right now is fully locked down. I mean, like literally it's more strict than we've ever been over here in terms of the lockdowns. And we're 18 months past, you know, when this thing started. And I remember saying to all of our teams around the world that the prophet Zechariah, he said, you know, return to your stronghold, you prisoners of hope. Mm. And I said, so we are all, in a sense, we're prisoners right now. That's the bottom line, is nobody gets a choice here. We are all prisoners. So we don't get to choose the fact that we're prisoners, but we do get to choose the kind of prisoners that we're going to be. And we don't have to be prisoners of despair or prisoners of doubt or prisoners of insecurity or fear. We are going to be prisoners of hope. And now, we had this meeting in March 2020, so it was when the whole thing first happened. And I remember, and then it says in that scripture in Zechariah, straight after that, and the Lord says, and I will restore to you double. Mm. And he goes on and says to, you know, obviously the children of Israel, they're in exile, they're in captivity, and they're feeling like, there is no way we can rebuild what we had. And the Lord's like, you know what? You be a prisoner of hope and I am going to restore double. Well, here we are 18 months later. Yeah. And by the grace of God, I mean, during a global pandemic, we have more survivors in our care than ever before in the history of A21, more traffickers in jail, more supporters, more people reached. I mean, it didn't go double, it exceeded double. Like, you know, because I said to them, I go, I'm believing we're going to see double the amount of people rescued. We're going to see double the amount of traffickers in jail. We're going to see, I'm believing that somehow, if we remain in hope, because Jesus is this hope we have as an anchor for our soul, both firm and secure, and yes, there's pressure, and yes, Paul says, I'm hard pressed on all sides, you know. I mean, we read this stuff in the Bible, and we think, but I'm not the Apostle Paul. I haven't been, like, shipwrecked, and I haven't been stoned, or I haven't been in prison, or, you know, all of the things. And I was thinking this morning, in a sense, we are. I mean, what would Paul have felt like? Look, we think, here we go again. There's another wave of this thing again. There's another variant of this. Everyone's freaking out. And I'm like, imagine how Paul felt. He didn't plan to be in prison for 2 years or 3 years or five. And we think, you know, or our brothers and sisters in persecuted countries that have been either in prison or been beheaded or lost their lives for being Jesus followers. And we are losing our minds over the fact that this thing's going on. I just kept thinking, what's in us will come out of us. And the Lord wants to purify what's in us. So if Jesus is this hope that we have as an anchor for our soul, both firm and secure, if he's in me, when I get squeezed, guess what's going to come out of me? Hope. Because it's got nothing to do with the economy or politics or the environment. It's Jesus. And he hasn't gone anywhere. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And so I'm like, y'all, we need to run some laps because we've still got Jesus. That's not minimizing, dismissing, or ignoring the reality of our external circumstances. But when are we going to believe the Bible where Paul says, you know what? All this is going on, but I am still full of hope and I'm still full of joy and I'm still full of peace. So I've decided 2021, I'm going to be unapologetic about the joy, the peace, just the abundance that I feel. And I'm living in the same world with the same problems and the same trials as everyone else. But what's in me is greater than what's going on around
me. That's right. Hallelujah. That's right.
Make me preach. White
I'm going to text you an offering. Wait, I got a text. Is it text to give? I got to get a text to give.
That's right. That's right. You know why? Because change is permanent, but growth is optional. In other words, there was already problems when Paul was alive, right? But Paul made up his mind he wasn't getting out of here alive either, right? And neither are we, whether there's COVID or not. It's not up to us. COVID's not the problem. We have to know, like Christine just said, that Jesus is the answer. And of course, we need to be respectful of whatever it is that is happening around us. But yes, Christine, I totally agree with what you just said.
You know, it's just listening to all of you, and so grateful for my sisters in Christ. I mean, so grateful. We're all so different. We've come from different places. But it's what you said, Christine. It's like squeezes as tight as you like, and what is going to come out is the light of the world. That's Amen. Our prayer.
I hope you enjoyed this video. Subscribe today, and you'll never miss a new upload.
And don't forget to check out our Better Together shop. Thanks for being a part of our community.